So what is chiropractic? That's a question that I get often in the office. And to answer that, we have to talk a little bit about stress and how stress negatively impacts our bodies. So to really understand chiropractic, you have to understand stress. And as humans, we are under tremendous amounts of stress, whether it's physical stress. The three main types of stress are physical stress, chemical stress, and emotional slash spiritual stress. And to address those three, and I'm sure there's more, that's probably not an exhaustive list, but those are the three main players in the game of stress. So the physical stress can be subdivided into two categories. You have your macro traumas and your micro traumas. Macro traumas are kind of obvious. Those are things like car accidents and slips and falls, injuries, lifting improperly, contact sports, trampolines, gymnastics, you name it. Things that we have in terms of impact. And we think that car accidents that, if it's it was just a minor car accident or just a little fender bender, but in terms of the statistics, a 10 mile an hour car accident. So if you hit someone going 10 or someone hits you going 10 miles an hour, that's the equivalent of having a 50 pound weight dropped on your body from a two-story building. So even a small accident can actually cause damage. The problem is, part of the problem culturally is that we judge injuries by severe pain, broken bones, or blood. So if you didn't have severe pain, a broken bone, or were bleeding, we don't really consider that you were injured. But lots of damage can occur short of those three things. So those are your macro traumas, your big T, big impact traumas. And then your micro traumas are things we do over time, like improper posture, sitting at a desk all day. We know that they're now calling sitting the new smoking because some of the same chronic health indicators tend to happen when you sit all day versus it's similar to the way that we get when we smoke. So cardiovascular disease, obesity, lung issues, and chronic problems with kidney disease. Those are all problems that are similar to smoking as with sitting. So the other things with posture are sleeping on your stomach. We kind of jokingly say in the office that tummies is for dummies because when you're sleeping on your stomach, your neck is rotated, your back is hyperextended. You got to put one leg out in order to sleep in that position. So it's not a posture we would go through life in, and it's certainly not something that we should sleep in for 8 to 10 hours a day, or 7 to 8 hours, or 5 or 6, depending on how much you sleep. So the other postural issues are looking at our phones all day. The average kid spends about 6 hours a day on some sort of media device, whether it's a phone or an iPad or sitting in desk in a class. It's at least 6 hours every day. So those are your physical forms of stress. Your chemical stress is mainly the food that we eat. And we'll do a deeper dive in another video, but all the processed foods and the sugars and the refined drinks and the gluten and the processed dairy, those are all chemical toxins to our body. And the other form of toxins are things that we put in and on our skin, namely our personal care products and our cleaning products. And again, we'll dive deeper into those in a later video. So your physical stress, your chemical stress, and then your emotional slash spiritual stress. And if you guys don't think we're under some sort of spiritual attack right now, I think we're kind of living in la la land if we don't believe that. But spiritual stress is a real thing. And then also emotional stress. If you look at someone who, lives in resentment or is bitter or has tons of self-pity, that affects their posture. It affects their mood. You think of someone, picture someone who's depressed versus someone who feels alive and who feels confident. Their posture is completely different. So physical stressors, chemical stressors, and emotional slash spiritual stressors are the big three. And the way that works is our nervous system is designed to process and deal with and name and create a reaction to all of those stressors, whether it's a bad food or whether it's a slip and fall or whether it's someone cuts you off on traffic and you're raging at them. So those are all processed by the nervous system through the spinal cord, out the nerves, into all the organs. And your spinal column works a lot like your fuse box.
Fuse box is
where the
our
power enters the house and then is distributed throughout the rest of the house. Just like your spine, the brain is making electricity, neurochemical electricity, sending it down the spinal cord, out the nerves, into all the organs, cells, and tissues of the body. It's the distributor system of all the energy in the body. So if the spine moves out of alignment due to physical stress, a fall, or a car wreck, or too much time at the computer, or we eat too much toxic food, or smoke, or drink too much, it causes our body to lock into a defensive posture, thereby interfering with the nerves. So that's really the name of it. That's called subluxation. So a chiropractor's job, just like in the house, is to find the fuse that's out of alignment, where the breakers tripped, and then we turn that power back on. That's essentially all we do. So now the problem is we can turn your breaker back on every day for the rest of your life, but if you're not dealing with and creating other mechanisms to cope with the oncoming stress, you're just going to keep tripping the breaker. So that's the name of the game, is get the nervous system healthy, keep it running without interference through regular chiropractic care, corrective specific chiropractic care, and then also reducing the income of or the intake of stress. So that's chiropractic in a nutshell. It's based on how our bodies deal with stress, and we always give at the weakest link. So when we give to stress, we always do that at the weakest part of our fuse box, so the weakest part of our spinal column. So let's say you had a car wreck when you were 16 and gave you whiplash. So that creates a weak link in the lower part of your neck. So that way when stress overrides the system, we tend to blow that fuse at the weakest spot, which for a lot of people, so many people have car accidents and falls and injuries. We always tend to give at the weakest link. I've never in 20 years, I've been doing this a long time, never heard anybody say, I hold all my stress in my pinky. Every time I get stressed, my pinky just aches and it throbs. Like, nobody says that. The stress always is held in their upper back, in their mid back, or in their lower back. That's where the stress accumulates, which is around the central nervous system, spine, spinal cord, and fuse box. So that's chiropractic in a nutshell. Please ask us if you have further questions, but I would encourage you just to stay on your regular treatment plan with chiropractic care. Tell your friends and family, because most people don't know about this. It's, you know, in my biased opinion, it's the best kept secret in healthcare. We get to see miracles all day long because we allow the body to heal itself. We remove the interference and the body's allowed to heal, because that's just how we're designed. So hope this helps. Thank you very much. God bless.